Here we go, everybody.
Oh, my. Only one person alive knows that move.
He knocks it away, then restrains him passionately and kisses his imposter. They face each other.
Always wanted to do that.
He caresses the imposter's face.
Oh, Angelica.
He rips off part of her fake beard.
Hello, Jack. Are you impressed? I think I almost killed you once or twice there.
I'm touched at this most sincerest form of flattery.
He removes her hat with his sword.
But why?
She doffs a mangy wig.
You were the only pirate I thought I could pass for.
That is not a compliment.
She rips open the top of her shirt.
Don't worry, Jack. I forgave you a long time ago.
For what? For leaving you?
Recall that I left you.
A gentleman allowed.
Look, Sparrow, as long as my sailors get their money, they're willing to put up with any number of peculiarities.
Ah, there is one peculiarity with which I will not put up with. I will be impersonated as captain, nothing less.
Well, for that you need a ship. And as it turns out, I have one.
I could use a ship.
I hear tell you've been to the fountain.
There'll be a lot of hear-telling going on these days.
The fountain of youth.
Dearest Angelica, fret not. You still have a few usable years left.
Ah, always so sharp. You didn't answer me.
Hey, I regard the fountain. Waste of time.
Milady, I see unseemanlike fellows of an officious looking nature.
Angelica draws her sword. Seeing palace guards in the tavern, she shuts and locks the storeroom door.
Friends of yours?
I may have unintentionally slighted some king or other.
The short, grimy sailor braces the door.
You haven't changed them.
Implying the need.
Yes. You betrayed me. You seduced me and you used me. I was innocent of the ways of men.
You demonstrated a lot of technique for someone I supposedly corrupted.
Imminent danger. Here now, villain.
I was ready to take my vows. And you... What were you doing in a Spanish convent, anyway?
Mistook it for a brothel. Honest mistake.
The sailor runs away from the door, and the palace guards barge through. Angelica attacks a few of them. Jack does the same. They sword fight around the fire pit. The short sailor runs out. Jack blocks a guard's bayonet, then elbows him. Angelica swipes at one of her attackers. More guards swarm into the storeroom.
We are at a disadvantage.
Speak for yourself. Unlike some who pretend to be, I cannot in fact hold a candle to.
I am Captain Jack Sparrow.
He slices open two beer barrels, drenching the palace guards. Angelica chops a third one open. As the guards slip and fall, Jack chops a smaller barrel at them. He cuts open yet another and red wine streams out. He starts to take a little drink, but Angelica pulls him back. The guards surround them, creeping in with their bayonets poised. Jack ducks as Angelica swipes her sword. She strikes a lever. A trap door opens beneath her and Jack, dropping them into a body of water. The guards peer down to find them swimming off. A safe distance away, they resurface.
How can you say I used them?
You know exactly how.
I know, but how can you say it?
She follows him. They swim to a riverbank underneath a bridge.
So what is it?
What is what?
About the fountain. What do you know?
He dumps water out of his boot.
You don't happen to be in possession of two silver chalices, Sir Ponce de Leon?
No.
Ha, thought not.
Why?
I hear stories. Romans. You are, of course, aware of the ritual.
Yes, I am.
What is it? What is required?
He jolts suddenly. Feeling at his neck, he pulls out a tiny dart.
A mermaid, Jack.
He collapses, revealing a tall figure standing in an archway behind him. Angelica smiles. To a prison gallows.